If this was just a Harley Quinn movie, which it kind of seems to be, or a Gotham City Sirens movie, which we all wish it was, this advertising would be absolutely perfect. In fact, it's so good that despite its obvious things that it's left out, right? Like the rest of the cast, we'll talk about that. It's hard to be mad, because it's so amazing. All right, so these posters and the trailer tomorrow, full coverage. I've heard it debuts around noon Eastern Standard Time, just like these posters did. That's Warner Brothers' debut time of choice. But these are coming out for The Perfect Storm, that is her ex-boyfriend's movie, and New York Comic Con, where Harley will be front and center. At the DC booth, they're saying they're going to have not before seen costumes from this movie, although we've had so many set photos, it's been glorious. I'd be surprised what costumes might be left. I'd be like, you might think we didn't see them, but we saw them. And then also these posters on billboards around the Jacob Javits Center. And then also there's going to be a spotlight on the DCEU animated series for Harley Quinn that's coming up. That also looks, that's like just a straight up Harley Quinn series with Poison Ivy as the supporting character. And I think that's going to be really strong because it is what it is, instead of having this ridiculous Birds of Prey. Because you know, there's like a still for the trailer that also came out today, and you look at it and you're like, why are all these other characters in the movie? I just care about Harley because they're so much lower energy and they're not as exciting or visually interesting that your eye is immediately drawn to Margot Robbie. I told you again, she wanted that to be the case. And many of you didn't believe me, but I think the evidence is irrefutable at this point. So I think that any screen time, we'll see how it plays in the trailer. I mean, unless they have amazing action sequences. And they both should, Huntress and Black Canary. You're going to be like, why did we cut away from Harley, who's perfect for these other DC characters who are not on brand, right? All right, so, and by the way, now you know what it's like to be a comic book reader these days, because Harley is everywhere. That's what it's like for us at the comic book store while I buy mine digitally, and now you can see what it's like in the mainstream. And her movie doesn't even come out until February. I hope Wonder Woman 1984 gets this kind of amazing promotion. It is the same ad team, so it should. And if I were Warner Brothers, they want to make a Gotham City Siren movie. If Birds of Prey does well, that will be like the next on their checklist. But instead of having like Batman be the villain for that, or getting someone like Black Mask, I would be considering Wonder Woman to fight them there. Do, you know, like that fabulous, fantabulous animated episode where Batgirl and Supergirl teamed up to fight Livewire, Poison Ivy, and Harley Quinn. It's one of the best animated episodes ever done, Girls Night Out. And I would love to see Gal Gadot join this group. It would be amazing! All right, so In the Mood for Mayhem, by the way, was the tagline they tweeted out today, and that's also fantabulous. It's hard to be angry because the Harley Quinn stuff is so good, and also I think many of you are like behind me in your emotional situation because I've already been angry about Margot Robbie taking this all for herself and being disrespectful of the other characters, so I've kind of moved past it. It is what it is, and I do feel a little bit better seeing many of you finally acknowledge what is so obvious. So that's why I'm in a little bit of a better place. And the good news is that means you'll eventually get there too. And you can just enjoy the Harley parts of this. Now, if Harley had her Suicide Squad longer hair, as she does in this roller derby scene, this photo leaked out or was put out last week, I think this would truly be Harley Quinn. Again, many of you pointed out that I was correct. Hair does make a difference. And I think if she had the softer, longer hair, she would look really great. But I'd say still, she's pretty darn close. But on a side note, with the shorter, lighter hair and the tomboyish figure compared to Suicide Squad, Suicide Squad Harley Quinn was very cheesecake, but here she seems almost flat-chested. Again, very tomboyish. And so the female gaze here continues to be, gaze, G-A-Z-E, continues to be very strong. And I'm very curious, by the way, to see what James Gunn does with the character. Margot Robbie, of course, now produces the Harley Quinn movies, so I think she'll have a very strong say in what happens to her in James Gunn's Suicide Squad, but I would think to some degree she would trust him because of the success he's had with Guardians of the Galaxy. So I'm just curious to see when they come together or clash on set. I think we all just want to see what that version of Harley's going to look like. That's the great thing about Harley. She always has a different outfit. It's a really good idea. It's fantastic. I don't know how if this appeals to guys, though, because they've taken away some of the sex appeal and she's become a fashion plate. But I'm certainly enjoying it. Now, with four new posters, it is kind of weird that Huntress and Black Canary, the actual birds of prey, couldn't even get one poster, even a poster to share. And then also Black Mask, who's Ewan McGregor, by the way, doesn't get a poster. And you could put Victor Zsasz on there. I would have done character posters for this movie because those are iconic DC characters. And if you're going to put these posters all around New York Comic Con, which is full of fans, I think they would have gotten a kick out of, I mean, unless, you know, you don't want to annoy them because those characters are, again, so off-brand. But it is kind of weird and disrespectful, and that's not going to go away. Maybe Margot Robbie made a mistake and thought that those characters weren't as popular as Poison Ivy and Catwoman. And they certainly aren't in the mainstream consciousness, but for hardcore fans, which are the foundation of any comic book movie, they know who those characters are, and they have a very strong relationship with them. Okay, so let's go through these posters, these four new posters, and I'm going to go through them in the order of my favorites. And be sure to share your own rankings down below. I do suspect, though, that our rankings will be pretty close, because this is obviously the best poster! It's amazing! It's weird, it's funny, it's, as I said before, DC fans are fractured for each character because there are so many different versions of the character. So I think a lot of you coming from the video game world and who are familiar with the character, how she was introduced in the animated series, you're used to a darker, you know, black and red color palette, Harley Quinn. But if, you know, in the comics, she's become this, kaleidoscope of colors, right? And as I said, very LGBT-friendly character. It continues, again, why Poison Ivy isn't in this movie, which is because it has such strong LGBT aspects and their relationship is so pivotal that it's even in the animated series. You know, the new one and the old one where it originated is just such a weird missed opportunity to me. But you can still see the Harley Quinn pattern, you know, that looks great. And even on the blanket on the sofa, which I think is adorable. But the background, while this is very eye-catching and gorgeous, and I think, you know, particularly for women, although guys chime in here, this is very appealing. It does look almost like an ad in a fashion magazine, right? But she has her hyena here. So that's obviously that's another reason this is the best one. I don't know why this stupid BOP is on here. This has nothing to do with Birds of Prey. It's Harley Quinn. And although I like the way she graffitied her initials on there with the diamond pattern. I think that's fantastic. So that's Lou or Butterloo. I wonder if she'll have both hyenas. Since she's broken up with the Joker, and he's supposed to be the one who originally got those are his pets, which she takes, it's interesting that she would pick hyenas, because, you know, of the laughing connotation, especially if she's so over clowns. But as I said, she's basically a clown herself. But I just love Harley with her hyenas. It's gonna, if done correctly, it should be very much like Halle Berry in John Wick Chapter 3. I love her boots. As I've said before, I would love to raid Harley's shoe closet. They're amazing. They even have the diamond pattern on the heels. They're really nice boots. I used to own a pair of boots like that in black, but I'm really liking the gold. And I like the way they tie in with the jumpsuit. And you can see that the way the jumpsuit is put on there, it's over like the pair of shorts that she wears earlier on in the movie. Also, she has like a very, she's not particularly defined, you know, like that's why I said the female gaze. Like Harley doesn't do a lot of sit-ups apparently, right? I mean, usually when you see a bare midriff in entertainment, right? It's extremely well-toned, but here it's, I think, again, more female-friendly. You can see, we'll talk about her manicure in another photo. You can see it better there. I love the grenade with the XOXO on it and the lipstick print. It's just classic Harley. She's got both the baseball bat and the mallet. I prefer the oversized mallet, but since this Harley doesn't have any superpowers, I don't know if she'd be able to wield that thing. In the comics, she's a little juiced up. She's not like Captain America level, but she's just, you know, tweaked a little bit by Poison Ivy. So that's why she can do gymnastics and stuff, something that Margot Robbie does not do. But at least she's going to rollerblade in the movie. I do like my gymnastic Harley, though. But this looks just fantastic. I wish she was actually looking at Lou, which leads me to believe that Lou isn't actually in the photo with her. That's some photoshopping, because then you would think there'd be a little more interaction. But I wouldn't want to I mean, I don't know how they're going to handle the hyenas. They're vicious animals, okay, especially when they're not animated. But it's just fabulous. Okay, it's fantabulous. All right, so the second one, obviously her on the squad car, having smashed in the window with the mallet. That's great. She's eating here, as you can see. That's going to be her new thing in the movie. We've seen a number of on-set photos of her eating. Very Brad Pitt in the Ocean's movies. That was his gag where he was constantly eating. Margot Robbie has paid homage to it here. Let's see if she does it as effectively. Although I wish she'd had a bite out of that, because at first I wasn't sure what she was holding. So I wish that she had, you know, we don't want her to pull a Belle and be our guest where the food's in front of her, but she doesn't actually eat very much of it. So she's got to eat. You can see some of her crossed out tattoos here, but we've seen those before. There's a better tattoo change in another poster. But this is very, I like the cityscape in the background. It feels a little more Gotham. It has a darker color tone, which is a little bit more, I think, the Harley some people are used to. So I think it looks great. She also has short nails with jewelry, which is also very a female thing. Usually for, you know, for the male gaze, G-A-Z-E, you know, it's longer manicure, you know, that's considered like a little bit sexier, right? But this is a little more relatable. You know, she's swinging a lot of hardware. She doesn't want to break a nail. She doesn't have to worry about that. So you can see, speaking of her nails, I thought at first her nail polish was chipped, which I think would be very Harley. But instead, this is like actually a Harley, a diamond Harley Quinn pattern on her nails, which is really hard to do unless they're decals. But it looks very nice. I think it's a nice choice. And then, of course, you can see on the license plate, Birds of Prey, Harley Quinn, Gotham exempt. That's great. It's a great poster. It's great. I really wish this was a Gotham City Sirens movie, okay? That's what people are just going to think while they watch the entire movie. They'll be like, only Poison Ivy and Catwoman were in here. I've heard that Janelle Monáe is in the running for Catwoman, and I would really... I mean, I think they're going to race-bend one of them. They could actually race-bend both of those characters in different directions. If Janelle Monáe is either one, I will throw a little party. I'll be so happy. Okay. I like this poster next. Largely because of Margot Robbie's eyes. The way it's lit up, her eyes like look a little scary, a little ghost-like, and they really capture your attention. I think it's great. And I think her smile is particularly nice in this one. So I thought she looked, actually, of all the posters, she looks actually personally the best in this one. I like seeing the knee pads a little bit better on her jumpsuit there. So she's fashionable, but also ready to get down to business. And I like that she's changed the J on her arm. At first I was like, what's going on there? I thought maybe it was Poison Ivy coming out of the top of it, but she doesn't seem to have met that character yet in the DCEU, so she wouldn't be getting a tattoo in honor of her. But what she's done is she's turned that J into a mermaid's tail, which I think is pretty clever. She could have done a little more with the J, but I think they want you to realize that it's a changed tattoo. And that's a bullet going through a heart that she's sitting on. I would have made the bullet a different color because it's not totally clear what she's doing, but it's really cute. It's adorable. I could see these being really popular Valentine's Valentine's Day, of course, when the movie comes out. So, you know, that's a good angle for it. Right, you know, the week before Valentine's Day. Then, this is my least favorite one, because I don't really love the bird wings on her, because she's not a bird of, I don't believe she's going to be a member of the gang, actually. She's just going to work with them. Although they are bringing out a Birds of Prey comic that's going to be DC Black Label, which is for adults, which she's a member of the Birds of Prey, which is so highly insulting to Barbara Gordon, I can't believe it. It's bad enough it's in the DCEU, but to put it in the comics is nuts. I hope Barbara is at least somewhere in the comic. I just think this one was a little too small in what it was thinking. You know, just stepping on a little wad of gum. I mean, it's cute. I get what they're going for, but I'm like, ugh, gum, you know, like stepped on gum. Ugh. Like that scene of Elf. I still can't watch that scene of Elf when he eats the gum off the subway. I'm like, it's so disgusting. But I mean, so again, I get it. It's cute, but I think it's the least effective of all the posters. And she seems, her facial expression seems maybe trying just a little too hard there. It seems more put on instead of the natural, more natural expressions I think she has elsewhere. So I'm really excited to see this trailer. And I think that, as I said, I've gotten past what's going on with Black Canary and Huntress. And so maybe that's why. And also, I'm just such a big Harley Quinn fan that if you give me my Harley, you know, that's the thing with us fans. If you really give us a little, even just one thing that we love so much, pretty darn close to what we want, that goes a long way. So what do you think of these posters? What's your ranking? What stage of acceptance are you with the Birds of Prey movie that is really a Harley Quinn film? Who would you like to see cast as Poison Ivy and Catwoman? I don't know if Poison Ivy will be cast anytime soon, but Catwoman is supposed to be in The Batman. So we'll be getting that casting announcement pretty darn soon. And of course, join me tomorrow for the trailer, which I'll be doing a reaction to. And of course, a shot by shot. All right, share those thoughts down below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.